All right, man, peace. Hey, brothers, you ever have that one friend when you was young? One dude who always got caught up in some dumb shit, always getting in trouble, cops always looking for his ass. Maybe he was caught up in a little bit of this, a little bit of that. Whenever the cops would come and speak to his mother, what would the mother say? Oh, not my baby. You crazy. My baby would never do that. My baby's a law-abiding citizen. Jenny Buss is that mother in denial. She's that mother who never thinks ill of her favorite son. When she had Kobe Bryant, she said, well, whoever does not want to play with Kobe, I would not want them on the Lakers anyway. And now she's saying the same thing about LeBron James, as the sentiment that I was putting forth 2 years ago about this false narrative pertaining to stars wanting to play with LeBron James was entirely media driven. It was all bullshit. Now it's starting to be forced on the mainstream media to accept it, because they're starting to hear it from agents and players themselves, that they do not want to play with LeBron James. They do not like how he plays, and they understand that he's just trying to use them to amplify his own legacy. Well, Jenny Buss has decided to come to the defense of her star player, as she should, because she's that mother in denial. She's that mother who's going to keep saying, not my baby, until she has to go visit her son in some maximum security prison somewhere. So anyway, they're going to talk about it. I'm going to chime in.
I just want to play the soundbite where Jeannie talked about the allure of playing alongside LeBron in L.A.
There is no allure associated with playing alongside LeBron James in L.A. I'm still flabbergasted as to why any superstar would want to play alongside LeBron James with the way that he plays.
The burbling narrative that maybe star players don't want to play with LeBron.
I heard that about Kobe Bryant, too.
And that was true with him as well. The only reason why Kobe Bryant was able to win a couple of championships is because, number one, he's a great player. But number two, they had Phil Jackson and Tex Winter to act as a buffer in between Kobe Bryant and the other prominent players on the team. So they were not subjected to 100% Kobe, because Phil Jackson would always be there to tell Kobe, Kobe, calm down and be quiet. Just shut the fuck up. When Kobe would be going through his malicious, borderline sadistic tirades against his teammates, Phil Jackson would step in and act as that buffer. That's why Dwight Howard said what while he was there with the Lakers. He was hoping that they would bring back Phil Jackson, but that never happened because Dwight Howard felt like Phil Jackson would act as a go-between in between him and Kobe because they had nothing in common. And now, of course, six, seven years later, we find out Kobe probably did not like Dwight Howard, because Dwight Howard was more concerned with backing men down in the low post off the court than he was on the court. Maybe Kobe Bryant knew about that shit. Who the hell knows?
And that makes me laugh, because if somebody doesn't want to play with the best player playing in the NBA right now, then I don't want them on the team.
Right, but supposedly the media narrative is you're not supposed to want to play with other great players. You're supposed to want to do it on your own. That's what we heard 5, 6 years ago. Now all of a sudden everybody is supposed to want to team up with LeBron James.
I love that, because she was very strong on that, and you said burbling, which made me...
Was she really strong, or is she just talking shit? Is that just hot air? Once again, with that metaphor of the mother in denial. The mother in denial, she already knows that her son is a badass. She knows that already. But she's just hoping for the best, and she's showing a mother's loyalty. Deep down, Jenny Buss knows. She's heard rumblings. I mean, at least if she's aware of what's going on around her. She knew why people did not want to play alongside Kobe Bryant, and she knows why people do not want to play alongside LeBron James. I'm sure that Luke Walton has confided in her and let her know what he thinks is going on with LeBron James and Magic Johnson and Rob Pelinka. So she's aware, but she has to fall back because Magic Johnson is in control of everything.
Made me happy. Tracy, here are the top potential free agents in the summer. Do you think one of these guys will get lured to the Lakers?
I don't know. I don't think so.
Tracy, you mean none of these guys are going to go to the Lakers? Damn, why not?
I don't see Kevin Durant. I don't see Kawhi coming to the Lakers. Those
Thompson,
are big names for me.
Stay where he's going to be.
The perfect fit out of all those guys is Klay Thompson.
Of course, but he fits everywhere.
Perfect.
Klay Thompson, once again, as Zach Lowe already stated, he fits everywhere because he can catch and shoot and he plays defense.
But he said on this show, on the jump, Klay Thompson said, I'd like to stay here and go to
I don't
to
see
State.
None of those guys come.
For Klay Thompson to leave Golden State, Steve Kerr and Bob Myers and the owner Joe Lacob would have to walk up to him in the locker room and call him a sack of shit. And he might still say, guys, you're joking? Is this a joke? You guys are so funny.
I was coming to the Lakers.
If you had to give me one to pick out of that group as like the maybe, is DeMarcus Cousins is actually an interesting name to watch for them, I think.
It'd be good.
But anyway, that's basically it on that. I just thought that this segment was very interesting. Jeannie Buss once again showing that she's a quote-unquote ride-or-die chick for her badass son. Before it was Kobe, now it's LeBron. It's just very interesting that when these rumblings started to come out about Kobe Bryant, he was pretty much over the hill or starting to get over the hill. I believe that the first time that she uttered those denials was right before he tore his Achilles. So LeBron James seems to be hovering in that same area. He just turned 34, I believe. 34 was the year that Kobe Bryant finally had that big breakdown of his body. So we'll see how things go for Mr. LeBron James. So peace.